You'd be like roses in the spring, the smell of rain that it brings, sprinkled with a bit of angel dust. The first fresh cut of grass, a homemade maple tap, a mix of everything that I love. If I could bottle you.
It's videos like these that make me so happy to do what I do here on YouTube, and that is featuring some designers that are more small batch. I feel like I'm connected to part of the craft. A couple years ago is when I started wearing Elizabeth Suzanne pieces. When I started over on my personal style, I invested in some pieces that I could mix and match and still have a unique style. That's why I started with Elizabeth Suzanne back then, and it's fun 2 years later to be able to work with her on a video today. This video is not sponsored though, this was just something I wanted to put together in celebration of her new warm weather collection. So some of the pieces that are from the warm weather collection were gifted to me, so I will list that down in the description below, but I'm really happy today to be able to talk through some of these outfits that I put together, and let's get started. The first outfit is all silk crepe. I absolutely love their silk. It is just top of the line. It's not like something shiny, and it's not completely raw like a raw silk would be, but it's just somewhere in between to where you're not gonna have much for like it being see-through or anything. So this is the parabola top, which has more of a looser fit, and I just like that it's more of a boat neckline, and the whole thing is very gorgeous, but I'm really excited for these new pants. These are the Andes in moss. I have had the Andes before in a black color, and I'm gonna have another pair to show you guys later, but what's really cool about this color, it's somewhere in between a brown and a green. It's got an olive tone to it, which is really pretty. With the fact that it's also silk, it kind of reflects light in different ways, and I just actually really love the way that it looks with my hardwood floors. I know that sounds kind of silly. For shoes with this outfit, I went straight with something that's more my skin tone. These are from By Far. I featured them in a couple of different videos recently, and I'll also link you guys to some that are more similar as well. But I love them because they've got a thick heel in the back, and at the same time, they're strappy like a sandal, and yet they still feel like a mule. So all good things all the way around. For the purse, I'm using just a small nude colored purse as well. This is, I think it's in the color Sand. From Polen, and that's just a really fun purse that I'm gonna have a lot of great times with this summer. Next is the linen gauze bell skirt. This one is brand new, and it's gonna be great to be able to have this linen gauze. It's not something that you have to iron as much as like a linen or a silk or anything. This is something very much that's going to just kind of go with the idea of having an effortless summer. And so with that idea, I'm wearing it with a crop top, which is also extremely effortless, and it works with something that's more of a high rise like this. And so the crop top is something that I would say is what I would wear as an essential in my closet. I actually did a video on that recently if you want more info on like the essentials, the most, like the must-haves in my closet. And wearing a crop top in summertime is just so perfect. I wear these to the gym. I wear them with formal things like a beautiful skirt like this, and I can just kind of mix and match in that way. So that shirt is from Everlane. And then the shoes that I'm wearing today are from, I'm gonna pronounce it Dora Torre, and that's probably wrong, but they are so gorgeous. I just love that they have this little leather bow tie on the front of them, and that it's got like more of a kitten heel too, and then the velvet like suede on the top is just so very chic kind of vamp. The purse that I'm wearing today is very much in the same spirit as the shoes, where it's got the depth of having that dark rich black color on it, and then it's got different tones of the suede versus the regular leather that's on it, and then the brass details on it as well are just, the whole thing just really makes this outfit come together and elevates the style of this purse more than a traditional or like understated purse would. So that purse is also by Polen, which is where that little cute sand colored purse was from. Next, this top is new to the warm weather collection from Elizabeth Suzanne. It's like in this charcoal pepper color. It's just so pretty as far as having little specks of white and black inside it, making it more of like this raw material. And I love that it's also in the linen gauze, which just brings more depth to what that color looks like. It's not just a basic gray. I also think that it's gonna be great for summertime to just have like a really pretty tank. I like that it's also kind of cropped almost. I actually, because I just am a little shorter, I probably will even get it tailored to be a little shorter on me as well. But for now, it works great just to tuck in to high-waisted pants. So the pants that I'm wearing today are the old, like these are ancient. These are what I wore when I first started my personal style, and I'm still wearing them. These are the Tildas from Elizabeth Suzanne. I wore these like every single week, and now I still wear them, sometimes even to bed. And then the combination of having linen and silk, you guys know those are like my two favorite fabrics, and together they just feel so appropriate for summertime. And it's just gonna be awesome to wear this around Nashville, which is extremely hot during the summer. And also, while I'm at it and taping this video, Liz, please bring back the Tildas. They were so nice and I would definitely buy more of those. I just like that they taper at the leg a little bit more. The Andes are awesome though, and that's kind of the closest pant that they have to the Tildas right now, to where they are still a little bit tapered, but not quite as much. And then for the purse with this outfit, I'm wearing the Malloy bag, and I just love that this is a helix. It's patent leather. It just adds a little bit of shine to this outfit, and I talked more at length about this in another video, so I will link you guys to that if you're interested. So jumping right into comparison, these are the Andy trousers in ivory. This again is in the silk. What I love about these is that they are still tapered, and they feel just light and bright in the white. So I like to be able to wear this with something like this one, which is the Everlane silk shirt. You guys have heard me talk about this plenty, but it's nice to be able to have something that's very classic in my closet. Again, this was one of my first purchases when I was starting over on my style, and I like that I can just wear them in different ways. So in this case, I'm wearing it kind of tied right in the middle, and that just highlights the high-waisted nature of my Andes. And together, these are both really quality silk pieces. So the shoes that I'm wearing with this add a little bit of personality and distinctness to this outfit. So I really like to be able to wear these. They are mules, and they have a little bit of a kitten heel to them, and then this beautiful black stripe on the front of them. Together with all of those elements, it just gives a very chic vibe to a shoe that has a lot of personality. This is a shoe I can't wear with every single outfit, but an outfit like this, which has basic colors, just the whole combination, I love so much. So with this black top and ivory pants, and then having the striped mules, I went with just a simple bag again. So I'm using the Polen sand colored bag. So it's just small and summery, as are the pants, and it just kind of makes this outfit more towards summer and warm weather than it would if I wore something like a darker or bigger bag. And for the last outfit, I'm wearing the artist dress. It reminds me a lot of another black dress that I had from Elizabeth Suzanne in the silk crepe, but now having something like this, which is linen and very breathable and still not going to wrinkle that much by having the linen gauze as a version, is gonna be so great. Okay, so the boat neck is gonna be another great option as well for summertime, and everything's just very billowy and breezy. If billowy is something that you're trying to avoid though, I've got it with a little serpentine belt. It's just a thinner belt. She has different options as far as if you want a thicker belt for more of a kimono style, but I really like something like this, which will just kind of tie, and I can kind of adjust it to be something that is up high, or I can have it turned around so that the back is where the tie is, and so that just kind of has a more chic and put together look in my opinion. And then also it's great because I can lengthen my torso by having the belt up a little higher, but I actually really like the look of it without the belt too, and just having it kind of open and breezy for summertime. And with summertime in mind, I'm wearing the small Polen bag again, and then yet I decided that the best shoes with this look is really those Dora Tore heels that are gonna be really great to kind of match all together with the black in the outfit. So I'm not necessarily against combining one color for your shoes and one for your bag, but I think that it just comes down to how intentional it looks, and I think that it's gonna be really fun to wear this through summertime. So that's a wrap on these outfits. Let me know in the comments if you'd like me to feature any other like smaller brands as well. This was something that I did a lot last year, where I did like a Feature Friday, and that was super fun. I featured lots of different brands that you might not have heard about, ones that I'm just really proud to be part of the craft with. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Be one of a kind.
best I'll ever find.